they found out a lot of things. One thing they found out was that there was a murder in that house next door a long time ago. Three people have lived in it since the murder took place. The bloodstained floors were pulled up, and the bloodstains on the walls were painted over. There was three other people that lived there. Two of the people, one person and a family, didn't report anything strange going on. Another woman that lived there reported all kinds of things going on. She was Native American. She got a shaman to bless the house, and then everything seemed to stop over there. But when everyone moved out and the house became empty, everything started up again. What they told me was that there were Native American spirits who were on the property. While they were here, I was outside in the tent in the command center with them, and all of us could hear Native American drumming in the wood line. We could also hear musket fire. That was residual, was not, well, the musket fire was residual. The Native American spirits that are on the property are trying to protect my wife, who is also Cherokee, from a non-human spirit that is inside the house that is causing all this. I believe that's what I photographed in my window not long ago, which I'll put at the end of this video. I think that that's the Native American spirits have also been over here, which is why I see all the animals and the photographs of the anomalies that I've taken around the house. It all have seem to evolve around animals. There's one up in the laundry room window. It looks like an animal. It looks like an animal coming out of my floor that my dog noticed. There's a picture, darkened picture of my front door that my dog is staring at. Has a giant cat's head image on it. So there's a lot of animal references to all this. I'm still hearing footsteps. Last night I heard a lot of footsteps around the house. My bed was shaking last night. But I haven't been attacked anymore. And I think that the reason I was attacked and my wife wasn't attacked is because my wife is also Native American and I'm not. So, you know, I'm the white devil. So let me get attacked. But, I was scratched really badly twice, once while I was awake. So I knew it wasn't natural. It wasn't anything I did to myself. It just appeared on my leg, once on each leg. So the paranormal group said that the entity that was over there was too strong. They couldn't get rid of it. They did say a blessing over our house. I'm not sure how much that helped. Seems to have helped a little. But the activity is jumping over here from over there. So the activity is not lingering in my house, and it's not originating in my house, and it's not contained in my house. It comes over from the other building. I think that the animal anomalies that I saw, that I photographed, were the Native Americans attempting to protect my wife from whatever was in that window that I took a picture of. I got another picture in that window. I'll put it at the end of this video. I have absolutely no idea what that was. It was blue. It looked female. But it still looked animalistic. It looked like a mountain lion with like a bishop's hat on. Just weird. I don't know what it is. But I have recorded quite a few EVPs here. The latest one was today. I recorded a voice in the master bathroom where most of the activity is now. And the voice said, "Goodbye, Guy. My name is Guyan. People call me Guy because it's easier to pronounce and remember." And it said, "Goodbye, Guy." So I don't know if that was them telling me they're leaving. I'm not sure if they've left yet. I won't know until tonight, until I go to bed and find out if my bed's still shaking or if I still hear footsteps around the house. But the problem remained. It wasn't taken care of or abolished. We're going to need to get a member of the clergy over here to bless both houses. My wife is an ordained minister. She did bless the property and this house. But we need someone higher up in the clergy, maybe a bishop status, to actually exercise that house, bless this house, and exercise and bless the property. So that's what we're working on now. Anything else happens, if I can record it in real time, I'll put it in a video. I don't know how to edit videos. You know, I'm not too far from 60 years old, so I'm not real good with that stuff, but I'll do what I can as I get more things recorded, but just thought I'd update you on what was going on.